I'll miss you too. I'll miss you too. I'll see you later on this afternoon. We gotta go spend some time in this truck today. It's time to go trucking. Good morning! How's it going? Oh, it's toasty warm in here. Oh boy, turn the heat down. Yikes.
Oh boy, another day is here. The earth went all the way around again. Nice. Oh, gotta get myself organized here. Everything is getting tangled. Oh no. Oh, here you are. It's my work hat. My bull's not work hat. I don't know why I brought my toque, but just in case. You never know when a freak snowstorm is gonna come. This is Manitoba. Why do I have these with me? I was gonna leave this in my pickup. Whoops. I gotta put this back. Oh, it's so hot in here. My air conditioning doesn't work. I'm gonna have to go talk to the shop. Please. I don't wanna die. I don't wanna melt. I need air conditioning. I am such a suck. I need my air conditioning. Imagine like people from 100 years ago listening to this vlog right now. Like, come on. I'll be okay. If I have a choice, I'd rather be comfortable. I believe I work better when I'm comfortable. They're working on it. We'll drag ourselves out front so that we are front of their mind. Then they'll find us something to do.
Going to be in the back corner. We'll look it over again just like we did yesterday, make sure there's no damage, make sure it's all set and good to go. It should be, and we'll be on our way. I think Arburg's about an hour and a half from here. It's 2 hours from our yard, and it's a half hour to here, and it's on the way to Arburg, so I'm guessing about an hour and a half. So I'm not in the biggest of big rushes today, but I also don't want to be late or just on time. If you're on time, you're late, right? So you want to be there a little early, or at least be in the area and be nearby early. If they want me there at 1 o'clock, I don't want to plug up their yard because maybe they have other appointments before me, and it's not the biggest yard. I've never been given an actual time to be there before, so this is new to me. But maybe this is to make things a little bit more organized. That would make sense. Anyway, let's go get our trailer. We're going to go talk to the good people in the office here and give them my autograph. give me a trailer.
Lots of trailers.
Lots of trailers. Oh boy. Oh, let's not take that one. Nope. Or that one. Look at this one up here. You see that? That one, someone didn't notice the low bridge warning sign, I guess. Skin the top off of that trailer. Oh, oh. Whoops! Whoopsie! And this roll tight is here still. It's been here a while already. I guess it's getting fixed. These are all the trailers getting fixed over here. That one doesn't seal very good anymore. That's the thing about these roll tights. You know, you catch one little thing on a corner or even a rock hits it sideways the wrong way and you got a huge tear in the side. But I mean, the tarps are pretty, it is pretty tough material. Still better than tarping. Still better than tarping. All the way here in the back corner, there's our green roll tights. We rent them for a while, then I bring them back. And then we come back and we rent them again for a little while and I bring them back. We're always running short on these things. I shouldn't say we're always. I should say we have been running short lately. But they're pretty expensive, so it's probably cheaper just to rent them when we need them for now. I don't deal with that side of it. They tell me to go pick one up, I go pick it up. That's what I do. Now, one of these is going to be mine. And I bet you I'm going to come pick up that other one soon. 70128, I think this one right here.
70128, let's check that.
Yeah, 70128, that's the one. Alrighty, let's hook her on up. And nice and smooth. And the click. There we go. Beautiful. Beautiful. Let's get out here and hook this thing up. Oh, there's one of our goose friends again. Do you know Wilbert? Wilbert's my buddy, all right? He'll vouch for me, okay? Don't attack me, please. Stay over there. Why are you looking at me? I'm looking at you because you're looking at me. Some geese. Oh, staring at me. Always challenging me to a fight. One of these days, I tell you. One of these days. I'm gonna take one on. I'll fight a goose. Keep looking at me that way. Okay, so now that we got the airlines connected, I can already see that light's working. Let's fill up the trailer with air. Start this up so the compressor is running. Light is working. Light is working. I don't know what this is doing here. Why is this here? Looks like it's supposed to be here. Oh, you can, I don't know what this is doing here. Because it's already got this handle here, so I thought maybe it's a handle. Why would this be here? You see that? What? What in tarnation? Put you in there. What? Huh? We'll have to figure that out before we go. Let's roll up the landing gear before we forget. Don't want to forget.
Which way? This way. Okay. Looks like they were freshly greased.
Nice. They feel like they were freshly greased too. You know there's two speeds for these landing gear, right? I met a driver at a truck stop in the States, and he was trying to get his gear rolled up, but they were sort of pinned to the ground, and he didn't know that if you move this, there's another gear. It's a lower gear. It just moves slower, but it makes it easier. Let me push it in. See how it goes faster. I thought that was something that they just taught
all drivers, but that driver didn't know that. Three. I don't know, he was in the US, huh? Saw him moving down the highway pretty swiftly later. So, at least he got his landing gear figured out and was able to get on his way. Hang that in there. Okay. Marker light and signal working. Beautiful. Please tell me there's air in the tires. Yes. Oh, you see, this one's got one of these on here too. Why do they put these on here? I don't need this to hold on to. I just hold on to the handle itself. What? But it's not our trailer, and they're like pinned on there, so I don't want to take them off. I mean, they're... That's weird. Mud flaps in place. Marker lights working. Signal lights working. There are no marker lights up there, but you got these three here. They've got to be on and working. Another one here. I don't like these things. I might take them off and put them back on when I'm done with it. I don't like that these are flapping around in the wind. I'm gonna take those off before I leave. And put them back when I'm done with it. Air in these tires too?
Yes.
Now for these roll tights, you gotta make sure that you have this. This bar here, that rolls up the back. And make sure that it's locked on. You see, this one's locked on there. I don't really like that it floats around like that. I'd probably put a bungee on it just to pin it in place so it doesn't flop around so much, but whatever, as long as it's not gonna fly out. Marker light and signal's working. Tractor lights are working. It should be, I checked that before I left. Marker light down here's working, and marker light, it's hard to see it in the sunlight, but you can barely tell that light is on and working. Okay, so let's go inside. Oh, how does this work? Ah, there we go. Make sure that, since it's a rental, we'll make sure it's clean, that there's no holes. Let me know if you guys see any holes, all right? Because I gotta report that before I pull it out of here so that they don't blame it on me. All looks good to me. Wonderful, wonderful. These roll tights still get dirty on the inside here, which makes me wonder about the seals, you know? Some dirt still does get in here, but the majority of it, 99% of it, or depending on what you think 99% is, maybe less than that, 99% doesn't get in, it protects it. We put the freight on here, tie it down, cover it up, and we're off to the races. Good to go, good to go. Oh, that's getting kind of worn there, but there's no hole in it yet. It's been a little bit old, but these things wear out. That happens. But yeah, we're good to go. It's clean. Let's get out of here. Watch your head on here, okay? The first time I pulled one of these, the first thing they said to me when I got in here was, watch your head. What's the first thing I did when I got out of here? Boom! Hit my head. So watch your head, okay? And it's locked in place. All right. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Oh look, they even got dump trailers, grain trailers. Any trailer you need, look at that. Okay, one more thing we gotta do before we leave. Now that the trailer is charged with air, we shut the truck off so you can listen for any air leaks. Here, because the truck suspension should have adjusted by now. No air leaks. We're gonna go all the way back here and make sure that the suspension in the trailer is filled and that there's no air leaks. Okay. Yeah, they're filled. You guys hear anything? Nope, no air leaks. And I can tell that the brakes, they were freshly greased over there. That's good.
Right on.
Okay.
Let's rock and roll.
through. You know what? I'm a nice guy. I'm gonna wait for this guy. Plus, he's gonna be a lot faster than me anyway. Turn that engine brake off. See, look at that, blue skies. There's that quick little system that went through.
Another successful day. That load is all ready for the driver to pull south. It is going to Michigan and Pennsylvania. Hey, Chef. Hi, buddy. Yeah, I missed you too, man. I missed you too. Come on, let's go outside. Come on. So the grass is slowly turning green, but it's taking its time because there's so much traffic. Dog's always walking over it, and we're in the backyard quite a bit. And you can see the difference here when you look at our yard and you look at the neighbor's yard. That's what having dogs does. So I've got to find some kind of pet-friendly fertilizer. Is there anything that you guys know about and can recommend to me in the comment section? We want to get this yard green and growing properly. It's high traffic, like I said, but it has to be pet friendly. We can't keep them out of the yard for however many hours just to let everything settle in and stuff, right? Because they need to go outside, and this is our only yard here right now. So do you have any ideas of what I can use? Because I want my yard to look more like that. And guys, don't let me forget, okay? 9 o'clock tonight, before 9 o'clock, or around 9 o'clock, I have to bring these flower pots inside. Get them. Get them. Come on, Diesel, he's not that much bigger than you. You're older, you got the experience. There you go. There you go, body slam, got him on the ground. Now pin him, pin him, pin him. Diesel still got it, but I think it's because Chevy lets him win. Because Chevy's quite a bit bigger and heavier. Diesel's just old. Just getting all full of grass, man. Don't bring that in the house. Bert's definitely gonna notice that. Oh, he almost got you there, Chev. He almost got you. Oh, body slam. Look at his facial expressions. Chevy, stop letting him win just because he's old. Get him! Get him, Chevy! They look so angry. Okay, guys. Chevy, Diesel, come here. Hey. 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 Guys, enough. Okay. There you go. Don't get carried away, okay? I don't need a trip to the vet yet.